possession. Sex. 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 Is an indication that this world is coming to an end. Sex here. Sex there. Sex everywhere. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a blessing sign. When a young girl, 18 years old, is sexing a 55-year-old man, Jesus is coming again. When a young girl is boasting that my father is good in bed, I am sleeping with my father, it means Jesus is coming again. When a 30-year-old girl who leaves school and do all kinds of things, the base person, worldly fashion, and old men have been reduced to foolish men because of sex. Jesus is coming again. Won't you say amen there?
Amen.
Immorality is a siren. You don't just watch it and laugh and go ahead. It's a sign that Jesus is coming again. Paul, speaking of the moral condition and characterizing our days, he said in Romans 1 verse 27, even their women exchange natural relations for the unnatural ones. In the same way, the men also abandoned natural relations with the women and were inflamed with lust for one another. Men sleeping with men. Men committed indecent acts with other men. Homosexuality, lesbianism, is a sign that Jesus is coming again. The Bible says in 2 Timothy chapter 3, it's not just about sex. It says people will be lovers of themselves. They will be lovers of money. They will be boastful. They will be proud. They will be abusive. They will be disobedient to parents. They will be ungrateful. They will be unholy, without love, unforgiving, slanderous, without self-control, brutal, no lovers of the cool. When you see men who betray you after you do the cool, Jesus is coming again. When you see people sacrificing their brothers and sisters, including their mothers, for Sakara, blood money, lovers of money, the love of money is the root of all evil. Boastful, proud, abusive. When you see these, Jesus, treacherous, rash, conceited, lovers of pleasure, more than lovers of God. If it were to be beaming, and Two-Face has stepped in here, or the former P-Square has stepped in here, the place we feel people's inability to relate with religious things is a sign they are lovers of pleasure more than lovers of God. Chelsea, Barcelona, Arsenal, Manchester, they worship that more than God. Don't look at it at all. Jesus is coming again. People who go to church, they have a form of godliness. But the Bible says they deny the power. In other words, hypocrites in church. Are you one? Are you a hypocrite? Do you talk about virtue and you practice vices? The Bible says before Jesus will come, people will go to church. They will have the form. They look like Christians, but they are not. Evil men and imposters will go from bad to where? Worse. Things will never get good. Bad to worse. Deceiving. And people will be deceived. Jesus is coming again.
Amen.
The last sign for me tonight is Jesus said before he comes, the gospel will be preached. It is fulfilled in this room.
Amen.
From Sunday, in fact, almost 2 months or a month ago, People came to this community, freed them there, taking care of people. This program is still financed by young people in this country. We never placed a bomb here for anybody to give us money, because Jesus said we should go and this gospel will be preached in all the world for a witness. It is against the city of Lagos. It's against those living in this place. If you are here, you have a brother, you have a sister, and you want him or her to be saved, when you leave tonight, tell him something is happening here, because the Bible says the gospel will be preached. It will be a witness that they hear. They have heard, but they did not repent. Or they were given the opportunity to hear. Remember, it was in the days of Noah. It was in the days of Noah. In the days of Noah, they were shouting. They were drinking. They were married. They were given to marry. People talk about everything. If this program were to be a wedding, it would be filled. The Bible says, when this gospel is preached, then the end will come. When gospel is preached, Revelation 16, verse 6, 14, verse 6 and 7 says, then I saw another angel flying in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel to preach unto them that dwell on the earth, to every nation, including Nigeria, to every tribe, to every tongue, to every people. God will give opportunity to every man, rich or poor, educated or uneducated, from the so-called developed world or from the dead world, whoever you are, wherever you are. That is why it's busy right now, and someone is watching via the internet. Ladies and gentlemen, and the Bible says this angel, this gospel, to be born is a siren. Revelations blazing siren. Fear God and give you glory, because the hour of his judgment has come. And worship him who made the heaven, the earth, the sea, and the fountains of waters. Jesus is coming again. Time is running out. Revelations blazing siren. The last great moment in world history. Great moment in the history of the world. It's not a united world. It's not the Holocaust world. It's not the peaceful world. It's not the hungerless world. It is not the strengthless world. I am here to announce, by the authority of God's word, that this event we are about to witness is that Jesus will bless through eternity. He will break the borders of life. He will come, and he will come. But before that, it says, John 1, verse 11, he came to his own people, and his own received him. Will you reject him? Friend, tonight, will you reject him? I'm going to make a special appeal right now. First, to those of us in this room, and wherever you are listening right now, I'm going to make a special call. Jesus wants to save you. God wants to save you. The Bible says he is coming again. The theme of Revelation is the blessing siren. It is something that the world is coming to an end. Maybe tonight. Maybe somebody's last night. Maybe tonight. Someone may not hear this again. Revelation 1. Verse 7. Behold, he comes with the clouds, and every eye shall see him. Behold, he comes. Revelation 22, verse 7. Behold, I come quickly. Revelation 22, verse 12. And behold, I am coming quickly, and my reward is with me. What are you doing? What reward will Jesus give you? What reward do you deserve from him? My brother, my sister, are you sure God will give you a reward for who? Revelation 22, verse 12. Amen.
Amen.
Even so, come, Lord Jesus. And the Bible says, Matthew 24, my last lesson of tonight, verse 34. Assuredly I say to you, this generation will by no means pass away till all these things are fulfilled. Right before our eyes, they are being fulfilled. He comes today. He comes today. A songwriter put it this way. The songwriter makes it this way, and I'm going to let them sing it. Whilst we sing that song, he said, it's almost time for the Lord to come. I hear the people say, the stars of heaven are growing dim. It must be the breaking of the day. The refrain say, oh, it must be the breaking of the day. Oh, it must be the breaking of the day. The night is almost gone. The day is almost here. When you hear that song, it's almost time. If you want to be part of Jesus' second coming, you mean it. Pause and sing that song. You want it to come, you will go with him. I want you to do me a favor. If you raise up your hand right now, you just raise up your hand right now. I want to go into your kingdom. The ushers are going to give you a piece of paper. You raise up your hand and say, Lord, you stand on your feet. And say, I want to make it to heaven. I want to make it to heaven. If I die tonight, I want my name to be the Lord. If that's your desire, can you raise up your hand? My brother, God bless you. Can you raise up your hand? No. All hands down. 1 minute. 1 minute. I want your hands to be down. Listen to me carefully. I am tired of focusing in Christian gatherings. This night, maybe it is somebody's last night. You want to say, Lord, and you are listening via the internet. You are in the comfort of your room, and you are saying, I want to meet this Jesus when he comes again. I want you to leave that behind. If you mean it, you leave that behind. Can we sing that song? If you mean it, stand by the feet. If you know the song, you can join us. We sing. There was a young man. He was flirting around. When we talk about moral depravity, the gospel flipped his heart. Instead of Johnson to make a decision that night, he took it as one of the church programs. We made one talk. He never made a decision. The same night, what was going on? I want to invite my ushers. When we are singing the text answer, and the word says it must be time for the waiting church. The waiting church are those who want to make it to heaven. To cast their pride aside. Some of you during this week, the message will be disturbing. You'll be proud based on what you know before. The Bible will challenge what you know. The song says, this is the time for those who want to go to heaven to cast away their pride with gathered loins and burning love to look for the coming or the breaking of the day. If you want to be part of this, they will give you a sheet of paper and I will instruct you after the song what to do with it. We call the ushers as we sing the text answer. As many as are willing, I want to talk to you tomorrow. I want to get your name, the contact, and I want to pray with you tonight. Let's share the people. Shall we sing the text answer?
It must be time for the waiting church to cast our pride away.
Change somebody's life.
Amen.
in this community. When you want to make a commitment and say, Lord, tomorrow I want to come at least with one person. I want you to raise up your hand as I offer prayer for you right now. I want to come with one person. Lord, I want to come with one person. Whether you are a guest, whether you are whoever you are, you say, I don't want to go to heaven alone. The Bible says the last days people will be selfish. I don't want to be part of them. Can you raise up your hand? We're going to sing. Please pardon me. Your hand will be out. We'll sing the last answer as I offer the benediction. Just raise up your hand. If you know it, join us. Let us sing it. We are no more guests. If you're a guest, you have been coming. You are part of this program. We want to change Nigeria. We want Nigeria to come alive. We want to be Africans. We want to live in view of eternity. It must be the breaking of the day. Go quickly out. The last answer.
Go quickly.
Come on, join them.
Blessed for the world. word that has proceeded out of the servant of God today, Pastor TK Mentor, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Our wonderful friends, we're so happy you're here once again to enjoy the program for today. Always remember that God is always here with wonderful messages for you. For you in your health, for you in your spiritual life. We're so grateful you're here. Our wonderful friends, just as the pastor said, please, just after now, you just hold on by the left side here, for you to have a word with him. And if you have any question whatsoever, when you're about leaving, by your left-hand side, you see a question box. Drop a question there, and by God's grace, your questions will be answered by the man of God. And also, if you have a prayer request, believe that there is no problem under the face of the earth that heaven cannot heal. Drop it at the prayer box just by your left there. And God's children will pray for you. And the Lord, the God that answered by fire, will hear you.
Amen.
Our wonderful friends, tomorrow the Lord is going to